I just told him to talk about it.
Oh,
yeah. Look at the
good boy. Good boy. Good boy.
Do that when they just kind of slam on the brakes in that downward transition. They don't engage into it. Just always just go forward right away again. And best traction side, just go a little bit more forward than normal and then bring them right back and test that transition that they stay working through their body into the brush. So long that your hands are coming a little bit back here, and then you're kicking your body away from them.
Right.
You want to get low and close to them. Very good. Good, okay. And so you're doing the shoulder and half pass work.
I started at half pass like this.
Okay, great. Yeah. Nice. You want to do the trot or can't work first?
Doesn't matter.
Okay, great. All right, so when you're ready, we'll pick him up back into the trot. Straighten. Good, one more time. A tiny bit lower in the neck and keep a little bit of activity, yeah? Little lower in the neck. Inside leg on, outside range, bring the shoulder in. Good job, that's it. Right, there the withers clearly came up as he engaged. Excellent, good. Good, straighten. 20 meter circle now, and just do a gentle lengthening over the open side of the arena, yeah? Gentle lengthening, make sure you can push a little bit. Nice, good job. Good job. Good, now you do your shoulder in, and when you feel that you supple through your inside aid, you take it into a shallow half pass. Oh, it's all right. A little bit more angled. Yep. Good. Straighten and shoulder in again. Yep. And one more time. Shoulder in, starting as soon as you can on the long side. And you just want to feel it. He's a little looser for your inside aid in the shoulder in. Eyes up on the short side. Yep. Good. Now, half pass and try and keep his body parallel at the long side. Yeah. They are beautiful. Good. Good. Circle 20 meters again. And he just came a little too high in the frame. A tiny, tiny bit. One more time. Yep, straight ahead. And reestablish the ground cover and the supplement. Good, bend him a little in the corner. Inside leg closes. Good job. Let the neck drop a tiny bit. Perfect here. Shoulder in. And half pass. Keep his body parallel to the long side. Eyes up. Good job. Super. Good. 20 meter circle. Rising cross. Stretch them a little forward, downward. Show them that you can.
Oh, there's a chest.
Good. Nose forward, upper body back. And not more forward, not more ground cover than that. You think that he stays a little collected behind, stretching in front, and your upper body stays back. Keep your weight over the deepest part of the saddle. Nose forward. Bring your collarbone an inch or two back. There you go. Yeah, sit there. That's better. Good. And back to the walk one. Beautiful. Good boy. Smaller concept than the walk. Yeah, good. Really nice. That's so good. Very good. And I loved how he was supple to the inside of his body before you went side into half pass. And you just think that, you know, in the shoulder in, if you keep the same flexion and bend in the half pass, there'll be a little too trailing in the haunches.
Yeah.
So just bring the haunches with you a little bit more, just like you did the last time. Very good.
When I do it at home, I'll do half side shoulder and half side.
Yeah.
I tried, but I think that's my mistake then.
I'm probably doing
too much.
In the half pass, there's more bend than in the shoulder.
Right.
So if you did it just like you did that last time, that was great.
Okay.
Good. And just change rein and extended walk. And when you're at this level of training, the most important thing is you see it. How easy can you make it for him? You know? Like how simple can you make the half pass? Like pretty much you just have to kind of sit there and you find your way into it. You're doing a very good job of not having to muscle it because he's so supple and so through. Good job. Good. One more long side and extended walk. Good. Engage your core a little bit, collarbones wide. Think a little bit about you're super loose in your position and he's super loose and you just need a little bit more positive tension in your core. Yeah? Good. Flatter in the neck. Flatter in the neck. Easy, buddy. Good job. All good. Walk again. Good. And one more long side and extended walk. Not quicker the tempo. When you give the rein, it's so important that he stays the same in the tempo, flatter in the neck. I want his neck like a flat board at the same height of the withers with his nose out. In self-carriage, in contact. Even flatter. Yeah, hands low. There, and then stay in contact. Don't let it quicken. Good. Chest open again. Yeah, good job. Right. Good. And then pick him back up to medium walk. Super. Good, okay. When you're ready, pick him back up again. And do a circle in the rising trot. Establish the trot you want. To take into your lateral work and then go sitting. We'll do the same in this other direction. shoulder and work down the neck's long side. Definitely not higher in the neck. Yep. That's a good height.
Still want to feel that he's really supple through the inside of his body as going to half time.
Yeah. Get a little tight on the inside ring.
He doesn't like step into my inside. He doesn't fill up the inside.
Inside ring, exactly. Yep. And you want to have a little flexion. You can almost lead him a little bit on that inside ring in the half tuck.
Okay.
So he doesn't get too straight. Yep. And you know, since you're working on collection with him now, there's kind of three main ways to collect the horse. One is through transitions where you deviate, like trot halt or canter walk, where you do them pretty quickly, with repetitions. The other one is through lateral work, where they're bent and moving sideways.
Yeah.
And the other one is just through a collecting half halt, yeah? Where you make the shorts a little higher and smaller. So those are the two things, those are the three things I'd be thinking about it in your collection work, yeah?
I was just working on trot halt.
Oh yeah?
Friday.
Perfect, that's great. That's great. Yeah. And he trots on pretty well, right?
Yeah.
It's just a downward transition that he has to work on.
Yeah.
And kind of, no matter how much you collect the horse, no matter how short you make the stride, you always want to feel that he's stretching your ring finger out with his pushing power of the hind legs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Even in a piaf or a canter pirouette, you don't want to have the feeling that the horse drops behind the contact. There's no energy coming through the body into the ring. Yeah. And that's kind of why he has the pulse right on, because he gets, it doesn't quite push through it as it sets it smaller. Lower and just give him a little push with your calf and keep him connected. Just kind of the idea you want to work towards.
Okay.
That's great. Okay, good. So let's do a little bit of the canter work. Are you doing canter walk canter stuff now?
Yeah.
Awesome. Are you doing half pass with him?
I played with it a little.
Yeah. Body back a little bit. Good. Fine, good. On the next long side, I love how straight he is. Just do it a forward, go forward and back. Yeah? You're gonna do that a lot.
Yeah.
Good, and left. Good. So you're gonna go medium canter to collective canter on the next long side. Close both legs a little bit and really let your seat have a bigger swing, okay? Go ahead. Close both legs and let your seat go. Soften and come. Here comes. That's better. Good. And collection again. Good. Bring him back a little more. Bring him back a little more. Good. So you want to do this, and your goal should be that you can go from medium canter towards a pirouette canter. Obviously, he's not totally ready for that yet. But within like 3 to 4 strides, yeah? So when you go forward, you want to go a little bit more forward, and then when you bring it back, you want to bring it a little bit more back. And don't be afraid to soften your hand a little bit when you go forward, yeah? And if he breaks or anything like that, then the correction is to go a little forward in the canter right away, yeah? One circle here. Upper body back. Put your weight on your seat. Relax your hands. Just a little bit forward on the circle. That's good. That's good. Nice. Good job. Good. Okay, one more. On the next long side, go to a medium canter. Look straight ahead. Sit heavy. Let him take your whole weight. There, go forward. Yeah, good. And then collect again. Good job. 20-meter circle down there. That's nice. On the open side of the circle, go a little forward again. Let him feel all of your weight. There, I like that better. Good. And relax again on your outside rein. Right? Smaller stride, smaller stride. Good. Good. Exactly. That's a nice canter. Okay. On the next long side, you do a 10-meter circle. And as you're coming to the rail, you do a canter walk transition. Let him feel all of your weight. Yeah, touch him with the whip very softly. Just feel like you get too slow. Good, nice, great. Good job. Good job. So, that's just something for the homework that going forward in the camp or back. And you've got to go. Stay it okay if I just hold the line for a minute?
Yeah. Yeah. Great.
great, but I'd love to see you get a little closer to him with your leg aids. So that way you always have a little bit of bend and you have a little bit more contact. Yeah. When you go on that smaller circle, your leg aids are a little bit too far off of him for him to really know exactly what his alignment is. Walk down the long side again. And again, the collarbone's wide. I'd love to see the front of your upper body not concave, but a little pushed out. Yeah. Kind of think that with your stomach, you push his nose a little bit out. That's beautiful. Good. Good. Not quicker in the tempo. Really straight here. Stay 4 feet off of the rail. The entire way around the rail. 4 feet off of the rail. If your heels relax down, your hands are a little in front of the saddle pad. Super. And take a deep breath and think, allow yourself, if you're holding your weight off of his back, take a deep breath and let your weight go down through the saddle. Yeah? He's got to start to, when you sit a little deeper, he's got to start bending his hind leg and taking a little bit of weight. Don't hide your weight from him. Good job. Pick him up in the medium walk again. And just thinking a little bit about the frame that worked for him to do the walk canter transition. Great. Now, have you worked on the turn on the hocks a little bit? Yeah, okay, good. Those are all a little tricky. Okay. So, stay 4 feet off the rail. Good. And you go into a little shoulder four. Right, a little left action, good. And you just make a box. Make a quarter turn on the haunch whenever you're ready. Good. Same thing again. A little lower than that. Here, good. Good, and do that again. Good. Good, one more time. Keep him lower. Okay. Now go straight ahead, stay in shoulder four. I want you to start in shoulder four left, and then whenever you're ready, on the next long side, you do a half turn on the haunches, yeah? But I want you to start in shoulder four left, keep that little bit of left flexion through the whole turn on the haunches, and even as you're going in the new direction, I want you to stay in shoulder four left. Smaller stride, yeah. No problem, good, stay in shoulder for left, exactly. Good, change your shoulder for right. Good, make a 90 degree turn. Good, that was better. Neck out a little high, yeah. Good, straight ahead, exactly. So go ahead and halt one second. So when you're doing a walk pirouette or turn on haunches, you want to feel like almost like a little shoulder in position. So you have him around your inside leg, loose through the inside rein, and you go into it in a shoulder in position. You make the strides as small as you want them to be in the turn. Okay. Yeah. If you go into it and the strides are this big, that's how big your circle is going to be behind it. Yeah. So try and make the strides short, and then when you turn, you think of a half pass. Good. So shoulder, little shoulder in, right? Outside leg back, no drifting in the shoulders. Little less flexion. Yeah. Great, that's great. Now you think of a half pass, you do a 9-3 turn, make the stride small. And bring the forehand around. Yeah, beautiful, well done. Drop the neck again, shoulder in feeling. And then again, just there he started to turn because your inside leg wasn't keeping straight, right? So that's the spinning. He's always got to be in front of and around your inside leg. Especially in pirouette work, okay? Lower the neck, connect with your outside rein. Good inside leg. I want to see more contact from your inside leg before the turn, during the turn, and after the turn. Smaller stride. That's the right idea. Good job. Now straighten. Exactly. Good. Can you feel what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Exactly. You don't want your inside leg hanging off of him and your outside leg going through the turn. Before you go into it, you want him good contact on the inside calf. It's like a pole that he bends. do it and through the turn. So you keep the same bend.
Right.
Good job. Yeah, one more time in each direction. Low in the neck, shoulder in position, small in the stride before you turn. You keep your inside leg on through the turn. You think of half pass. Bring the forehand around. Good job. Forehand around. Good. I liked it, except for it got a little low,
yeah.
High in the neck, right?
Yeah.
Good job. Make sure you nod and launch it in to start. Yeah, inside leg. Good. And back left. I like it, yeah?
Yeah.
Still a little bit more inside leg would be ideal. So you're kind of stepping a little between the two front legs before you start to pirouette. That inside hind leg should be coming, you should not be moving a ton as you do it. Good, nice, straight ahead. Still lower than that. Just go straight ahead and a slight shoulder in. Low in the neck, a little small in the stride, but keep it fluid. Good. And then shorten the stride. Inside leg stays on, and then you think of half pass. Good. That's nice. Good. No problem. Yeah, and you just want to know before you go into it, are you going to do a quarter one or a quarter half, right? All good. Do that one more time to the left, yeah? And just try and do a quarter pirouette from the next long side. Slide shoulder in. Same tempo, both legs feeling him, low in the frame, make the stride shorter, and then think half pass. Bring the shoulders around. Straight ahead. Don't let him spin. Yeah, don't let him do more than what you ask him for. If you're going to do a quarter pirouette, that inside leg better be made there, keeping connected to the outside rein as you straighten. One more time. Good, inside leg. Right, exactly. He can't take over though, that's trouble, yeah? Good, straight in. Good job. All right, very good. Try and feel before we'll do a couple more walk canter walk transitions. And try and feel before you canter on that you have a good frame and that you feel that he's not super long behind the saddle. That you feel like he's a little round from the back, but stretching and not rushing. Good. Stay on a 10-meter circle around me. Let the neck fall down. Clear like that. Excellent. And then from here you do the walk canter walk again. Let the neck fall down. Good job. And when you're ready, Good. Nice. Down smaller circle. Lower than that. Yep. Good. Before you do a transition, up or down, let him stretch a little bit. Good. And then when you're ready, walk. Good. Lower than that. Taking the contact a little forward downward. That way you know, yes, perfect, there. Bring him back and let him stretch a little forward downward. Right, now you have it, yeah? Now he's around. Yeah, great, exactly. That's how you can keep the hind legs connected. Good, now you do these transitions. Try and use your seat and your outside rein for the downward aspect. Good, smaller strides. Yep. Can't draw him right away, that's the right answer. Good job. Good. And I want you to encourage you, if you close both legs, that's kind of for forward,
right.
Yeah? I would try and teach him that you can keep the tempo with the width a little bit, yeah? So just get used to him thinking about, if you touch him with the width, he's got to get a little quicker, especially as you collect him. Good. Good. Now practice this tap tap. There, good. Little tap tap. Good. There, but yeah, lower the neck and bring it back again. Then tap back. Yeah, good. And go out. There, good. That was small stride. Good. Now go a little forward on the circle. A little forward. Good. And then you're going to bring it back almost to the canter you want to walk from. And tap with the right canter. Good job. He's got to question whether or not you want to walk. He's got to be committed. That's beautiful. To staying in the canter. Lower the neck, soften your hand. Go a little forward. Push it forward. Good job. The neck is longer and lower. Good. And then collection. And touch it softly with the whip as you make the stride smaller. Outside rein. If you feel like it's going to break, touch it with the whip. Bring it back. Bring it back. Bring it back more. And now go out. Good job. Good boy. Go forward. Go forward. Good. 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 And back towards collection. Yep. Both legs. Exactly. Go a little forward. That's the correction cut.
Okay.
Exactly. Let the neck longer. Good. And then collection again. Much up. Forward. Both legs. Come. Go forward. Make a correction when you go forward. Come. Come on. That's right. Good. Good. Let the neck down a little bit. Then see how much can you bring it back. And when you get a little struggling, go out of it. Go out of it. Go out of it. Push him. Push him. Yep. That's right. Good. One more time. Push it, push it. Yeah, right. If you bring him back and it starts to get difficult, you better be able to close both legs and he just goes right back into it. Super. And exhale a little high. Good. And then when you're ready, you bring him back and then you go to walk. He sticks his legs in the ground and halts behind his canter off. About that, he will collect. Good. Better? Good, that's fine. Yeah. What's the great bit of what's horrible? So he's just gotta stay a little lower in the neck so he can use his back. And if he does a step transition on the forehand right away, those high necks have to work.
Yeah.
Until he collects and he stays working, he's like, I don't know if I gotta go forward or if I have to walk. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good job. You go the other way one more time. Trying to be conscious about your line. Just let him walk in a little bit of a stretch position here. Good job. That's nice. I like that. If your legs stay in a canter position and with your seat and your outside rein, you ask them to collect, you shouldn't have to really push all the time as you're collecting them.
Right.
If he breaks, then you say, my legs were in canter position,
right.
Go forward in the canter. And then you test again. Bring him back. You can bring both legs slightly back in the canter position. And he's got to learn that that means he has to take smaller canter strides. Yeah. If he gets a little slow and you want to help him to engage and stay quick, I would use the whip for that. Yep. Good. This is nice. A little bit more stretch. Perfect. Now make the stride a little smaller. Touch him softly with the whip so he's thinking about his hind legs. Let the neck so drop a little bit. Exactly. That's better. That's shorter in his back. Can you feel that?
Yeah.
Excellent. That's what you got to be able to do in the canter. Next day, too high. Yep. Smaller stride. Little half hold on the outside rein. That's open. Good. Straighter for the outside rein. Go a little forward. Soft hands. Upper body back. Relax your hands. Go a little forward. Come. That's nice. That's much rounder now. Good job. Now go forward. Keep straight to the outside rein. Come on. A little forward. Get his legs jumping. There. Now. Good. Now a little collection. Outside leg stays back. Outside rein is smaller. Touch him softly with the whip. There, now he's like, now go forward again. Good. Go forward again. Little push. Good. Now a little outside rein. Both legs come a little back. Put your stirrups down. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. And then walk. Walk. Good. Crazy. That was great. That was really good. And it was great. I saw him kind of for the first time in the walk. You had a good frame. And then he started to have his pelvis and get rounder in his back.
And he stayed like under my feet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
It was like I could just sit here and see him.
Yeah. Good. And just walk one more time. That was great. And for him, that's so key that he learns to rotate that pelvis, take a little weight, and sit. Yeah. Upper body back, chest open, let the neck drop, left ring, pull the upper leg, good. And walk. Right, Tracy Monroe. Super.
That was nice.
We got a little high in the neck, a little short in the neck, but.
Look at him, he says, I'm tired.
Okay.
Look at him breathing.
The more you're playing this rubber band idea, that you lengthen the stride and go forward, and he really pushes through his body, then he stays dynamic as he collects, but still sits down. Yeah, that's right. Stretch him, you know, you don't have to have him that compact all the time, or he'll get a little stuck and fussy. So the way that I found works for me is that you just do this like 3 times in each direction.
Okay.
You know, don't grill him on it every single day. You know, do that like 3 times a week where you make him sit, you make him take weight, you make him stay in the canter, and you make him go forward. And just do that 3 times each direction for a couple days. Thanks. And just in that, watch the video and look at your body a little bit in that flexion. And you want to think that you stay deep in your seat, you stay open in your chest.
And getting a little
forward on it. You want to feel like always, for every age, your seat comes first, and then your rein. Yeah, so sit a little heavy, sit a little slower. Outside rein tells him every single stride, come back. And you just support him with your legs a little bit so he stays moving through this. Good job. And you'll know he's going to break it. That time he'll get slower, or you feel him get longer behind you, and then a little bit.
Hopefully Mark did too.
Good job.
When are you going to get on for lessons?
No, never have time.
You will. She's a good instructor. She's too easy, though, I told her. Said she needs to climb down on me. Because she's so nice, but she's excellent, I'll tell you. And I've taken from a few. Did you see that? He went, young. Good boy.
Is it over?
Almost. I'm not quite sure. It's been
5 minutes.
How long? 45 minutes. 55 minutes.